Wembley, on the 6th of May, 1972, and the biggest birthday party of them all, the centenary final of the Football Association Challenge Cup. The two finalists, Arsenal and Leeds United. Arsenal, four times winners of the cup, the last time just 12 months before, when they became the second club of this 20th century to win both cup and league championship in one season. And Leeds United, the favourites, yet attempting to win the cup for the first time in their history. But more than that, attempting to complete the first leg of the double themselves. The holders against the favourites. The South against the North, two of the game's super clubs. The scene, too, perfect. On the morning of the match, there'd been a fair amount of rain. But by kickoff time, the sky had lifted and lightened. There was a hint of blue overhead. The flags of more than 30 nations were flapping playfully. And Wembley, the old grey stadium, was wearing its broadest smile. Wedged tightly in their places, 100,000 people who'd happily paid £191,000 to be there. Record receipts for an FA Cup final at Wembley. There too, Her Majesty the Queen, the Duke of Edinburgh, and the Prime Minister, Mr. Edward Heath. The time, 3 o'clock. Commentator, Peter Jones.
We've talked about this one now for nearly 3 weeks. The talking is just about ready to finish, because in any second now, Mr. David Smith, coming from a very quiet village in Gloucestershire, he's anything but quiet, blows his whistle, and we're into this 1972 Cup final. And in the first 5 seconds, Alan Clark upends Alan Ball, and we have a free kick to Arsenal just inside the centre circle. Arsenal playing in this first half from right to left as we look down high above the halfway line. Simpson taking the free kick, short square to his left to George Graham. Graham keeping it going left to Bob McNabb. McNabb a 1-2 with Armstrong, and another one back to Armstrong, picked up by Radford just outside the Leeds penalty area, trying a square ball. It's picked up by Giles for Leeds, but Ball beats him and turns it square to Graham. Graham finding good space for Arsenal, halfway inside the Leeds half. Tries a reverse ball, but only finds the tall figure of Madeley, who heads it down to Giles. Giles turning, coming towards us. That's to the Leeds right. Downfield to Clark. Clark controls, turns it to his right to Lorimer. Lorimer goes round McNabb, but McNabb brings him down with a thumping tackle. And Mr. Smith coming over to have a word with McNabb and looking almost for the moment as if he might put his name in the book. That was a very severe tackle by Bob McNabb. Lorimer down on the floor just inside the Leeds half, and the book in fact has come out. Really a sensational start here, and Bob McNabb, the Arsenal left back, is having his name put in the book by Mr. Smith for a very severe tackle on Peter Lorimer, who's still down on the deck. A really quite sensational start. Free kick then to Leeds United, about 5 yards inside the Arsenal half on the right flank of Leeds. That is from left to right as we look down. The kick from Charlton, not a good one, but it finds Bremner, and Bremner spins it into the area, and Barnett has to go up and fist it away. But Mr. Smith right on the spot there and says there was a challenge on Barnett, an illegal challenge, so it's a free kick to Arsenal. And there was Jeff Barnett, 25 years of age, came in for Bob Wilson in the semi-final of the replay against Stoke City. He was an understudy to Gordon West for so long at Everton, an understudy to Bob Wilson for so long at Highbury, and here he is in his first cup final. He takes the free kick himself, turns it left to Simpson, the ever-reliable man in the Arsenal defence. Simpson turning it to his left to McNabb. McNabb and Bremner together, and McNabb gets the better of it, turns it right to George. George turning it out to McNabb again. Down the Arsenal left flank, back to Armstrong. The little figure of Armstrong works so well. The longest serving member on the Highbury staff turns it to his left to McNabb. McNabb just outside the area, puts it onto his right foot. A square short ball to Graham. Graham going to have a go at this one. And it goes over the bar, over the bar. And there was David Harvey coming into it just as it skimmed over. Good work there by George Graham. And we just had a score flash from Hampden up there. Celtic in the lead, 1-0 against Hibs. 1-0 up at Hampden Park here after a couple of minutes, no score. As David Harvey takes the goal kick himself, the ball halfway inside the Arsenal half. An overhead kick from Lorimer, and Clark's there, but really no danger for Barnett, who comes out, clasps it quite confidently, kicks it high into the sky. Now grey and blue, and the grain has stopped, thankfully, and the ball halfway inside the Leeds half. And it's Giles coming across. Giles and Story together, and the ball ricochets off Story into touch. Throw in to Leeds, I thought, but referee says no, it's a throw in to Arsenal. That collision between Story and Giles, which the whole world of football, I think, has been waiting for these past 3 weeks or so. But that went off without too much incident. Throw from Graham down the line to try and find Radford. Charlton comes over, puts it into touch, halfway inside the Leeds half. Graham taking the throw. Infield, a collision there between Lorimer and Story, and Lorimer comes away with it. Lorimer inside the centre circle, turning it to his left, to that far side now. And Leeds on the attack in that all-white strip, coming infield. A tremendous collision there from Story. Went in like an earth remover. Oh, dear, dear, dear. Must be a free kick. It is indeed. Taken quickly by Madeley. Turning it to Giles. Giles just inside the Arsenal half. Reverse ball to that far side. And it's Eddie Gray now, that left flank, the man who loves these open spaces. Gray still coming forward, brought down by Charlie George. We're having bodies falling all over the place. We can do without it. But Mr. Smith, I'm sure the man who can grasp the nettle firmly, he's got to do it, because this one could get out of hand. A pity, because there's so much quality there. We expect good football. Both these sides can produce it. A free kick then, another free kick to Leeds. It's Giles to take it. He does this sort of stuff so well. Arcs it in, the flag goes up on the far side for an offside against Alan Clark. Referee acknowledges it, but because Barnett's got possession, quite rightly allows play to go on, keeping it moving. The kick from Barnett inside the centre circle. Armstrong going forward. It's cleared by Norman Hunter just below us here, almost into touch, but Bob McNabb comes over and picks it up on the Arsenal left flank. George Graham loses his footing on the greasy top, picks himself up, turns it on to Armstrong. Armstrong to Radford. Charlton comes in and brings Radford down with a tremendous thump. Charlton says sorry, but it's a free kick to Arsenal, and Graham going up to take the free kick himself. In fact, leaves it. Plenty of time here, no need for hurry, and leaves it to Peter Simpson. Simpson, as always, with his jersey outside his shorts. Good run from Simpson, but well read there by Harvey. Harvey playing this afternoon instead of Welsh international Gary Sprake. Must have been a difficult decision for Don Reid, but Harvey's there. He's played the last five games, and here he is in the cup final at Wembley. He bowls it out to the left flank to Madeley. Madeley coming in field again, turns it to Giles. Giles, a quick ball, good stuff. Could have been a good ball to Eddie Gray. Ball goes into touch. 5.5 minutes gone into this first half here. The Centenary Cup final, still Arsenal nil, Leeds United nil, and a throw-in to Arsenal on their right flank on the far side, but it's picked up by Giles for Leeds. A reverse ball to Jones, touching it for the first time. What could have been a good ball, I think, from Jones out to the far-running Eddie Gray, but must surely have gone over the line. No, it didn't indeed, but no danger to Arsenal, because Barnett read that one well, goes over, picks it up, a little touch ball back from Pat Rice, and he will come out right to the edge of that white 18-yard line, showing up so clearly on this green turf. Long one downfield, headed back by Reaney, but only picked up by George for Arsenal, halfway inside the Leeds half, turning it to his left, just below us, to Armstrong. Armstrong trying to find ball, but only finds the tall figure of Charlton, who clears his lines, but only as far as Simpson, and Simpson in turn to Story, and Story to ball, halfway inside the Leeds half, now turning it back to Simpson. Simpson trying a 1-2 with Radford. Radford can't get hold of it, but Radford had made a back there for Norman Hunter, so it's a free kick to Leeds United, about 5 or 6 yards outside the Leeds 18-yard area. Hunter and Radford for a moment looking as if they might have a little go at each other there. Two Yorkshiremen, that might be quite interesting, I would think. John Radford from Yorkshire, but now, of course, very much an Arsenal man. Free kick taken and turned back quite sensibly to David Harvey so that he can have a look around and see a little bit of space up front for his front runners. Long, long, long high ball reaches the head of Clark, goes as far as Bremner. Bremner just inside the Arsenal half, switches it to that far side to Madeley. The sort of stuff that Bremner does so well, this reverse ball that can catch men out so often. Madeley back to Giles, not a good ball from Giles, spun off the outside of his left foot there and went into touch, picked up by one of these grey track-suited ball boys. And a throw to Arsenal. McClintock taking the throw to ball. Ball back to McClintock and in turn back to ball. McClintock going for the return, but they're very tight near that line on the far side. And in the end, almost inevitably, the ball goes into touch. But it's a throw into the cherry red shirts of Arsenal, just on the halfway line, almost alongside that red and yellow flag on the halfway line. A long one down to Radford. Radford challenged by Madeley. Ball goes into touch, and Mr. Smith, right alongside the player, says it's a throw into Leeds. Taken quickly and put infield to Hunter now. Hunter with this long stride of his, and a long ball downfield to Jones. Good work here by Jones, going down to the line. Danger possibly here for Arsenal. Turns round McClintock, turns it back to Clark. Clark trying to get round Rice, doesn't, but it rebounds and goes on to Jones. On that far side, the Leeds left. Leeds trying to find Giles in midfield. He's the man who's always there, but they have to leave it to Charlton. Charlton onto the head of Gray. Gray to his right here, to Lorimer. Almost off balance, but gets it forward. But some good work there by George Graham for Arsenal. Such a good player, this man. Deceptively languid-looking player, but so good, this Scottish international. And he sends a long one downfield, but it's picked up inside the centre circle by Giles. Giles turning it to his right to Madeley. Madeley infield to Charlton. And this organised defensive work of Leeds, but not so organised there with the free kick, with the kick, because Graham picks it up and tries to send McClintock away. McClintock turning it to ball. Ball twist, turns back towards his own goal, puts it onto his right foot, turns it downfield to Radford. Good work by Radford. Story goes in with a tremendous collision there between Story and Madeley. Story on the floor, and this time it's a free kick to Arsenal. Great collision there between the short, stocky, but powerful Story. 9 minutes gone into this first half. Still Arsenal nil, Leeds United nil in this centenary final. And a free kick to Arsenal. There's a white wall of Leeds players, 1, 2, 3, 4 of them. A clip ball from the ball, back to George. George shoots, but really not much angle, not much power on that one, and goes over the bar with no trouble at all there to David Harvey.
Both sides at this stage finding difficulty in settling down. Not because they were nervous, there wasn't a nerve end in sight, but simply because so much was at stake, simply because victory mattered so much. 14 minutes now into the first half.
Barnett to take the goal kick for Arsenal. It's a good kick, reaches 15 yards inside the Leeds half, but Giles is there, as the little terrier he is, to pick it up and turn it to his left, to the far side, to Gray. Gray going down the line, but Ball and Rice between them, Rob Gray, and Ball sends a long one downfield to Charlie George, but Charlton reads it, calmly lets it go through to David Harvey. The Leeds players obviously have great faith in Harvey, and Bremner tussling there with Graham, a little neat back heel by Bremner. He comes forward now, turns it to his right to Lorimer. Lorimer turning it also to his right to Clark. Clark on the edge of the 18-yard area, going forward. If he can, he turns it to the short ball back to Lorimer. Lorimer going down the byline. A dangerous-looking moment this. Jones's head is there, but very good work by McClintock. Heads it away, and Eddie Gray trying a first-time shot that goes over the bar and lands on the crescent of sand. But good work there by Leeds United with 15 minutes gone into this first half. Well, it's Arsenal trying the rhythm at the moment because it's Charlie George halfway inside the Leeds half, beckoning players to come to him, turns a ball to his left to Alan Ball, who has to run and pick it up, and in so doing slips on the turf, and Charlton picks it up and sends one downfield to Lorimer. Lorimer now accelerating forward for Leeds, down the right flank, he's gone round Simpson, he's going down the line, but some good work by Simpson, who puts the ball over the byline. Good recovery there by Simpson, because it looked for a moment as if Lorimer had gone round him. I thought it had gone for a corner, but Mr. Smith was right there. He obviously saw it ricochet off the white stocking of Peter Lorimer, so it's a goal kick to Arsenal. Such a dangerous player, Peter Lorimer. This man is said to have the hardest shot in football. Well, it's become almost a bit of a cliche now, but I know at least half a dozen first division goalkeepers who would guarantee that that is absolutely true. Easily the club's leading goal scorer, and not a man to allow in the penalty area. There was Hunter and Radford going up again at that moment. There seemed to be no danger at all, but they had a little bit of a go at each other, and it's a free kick to Leeds United against Radford. Radford and Hunter obviously going to have much more than a birthday party here, still wagging their heads at each other and having a little word. I'd like to know exactly what those words are. Charlton to take the free kick, finds the head of Mick Jones. Mick Jones trying to head it on again, but Pat Rice there nods the ball back to his goalkeeper, Jeff Barnett, as the sun comes out strongly here at Wembley, and Barnett taking the kick to that far side, slightly off balance, I think, and didn't get quite enough length, got more breadth than length. Gray trying to set Bremner going, but only finds Alan Ball. Ball turning it to his left to Armstrong. Armstrong to Ball, running well, but a very, very good sliding tackle there by Charlton. Throw into Arsenal, taken quickly by Armstrong. Armstrong to Graham. Graham onto his right foot, trying a 1-2, only finds the head of Hunter. Ball still halfway inside the Leeds half as Clark comes forward, but no trouble there for McClintock to sweep it away from Clark. Turn it to George, a 1-2, and this time it's George and Hunter having a little bit of a do at each other. George looking very aggrieved, Hunter equally aggrieved. Mr. Smith surely going to have a word with both of them. No, he has a word only with Norman Hunter. Hunter with his arms in appraisal, what did I do, what did I do? Well, he certainly did it a little too fiercely there. A great ball winner, of course, is Norman Hunter, but there are moments when he goes over the just a little bit too much, perhaps, and that was one of them. Mr. Smith again giving the free kick with no doubt at all, halfway inside the Leeds half, just about centre field. A good-looking free-kick position. There's turning it square to McClintock. McClintock tries a shot, and it almost went in! It almost went in! A great shot there by Frank McClintock, and Harvey had to swing away to that one and fall onto it, and Arsenal very nearly took the lead there, and that might well have been a crucial lead. Very, very good work there by McClintock after a short free-kick from Ball.
And at this point, Arsenal were conceding two free-kicks to every one by Leeds. David Smith, the referee, keeping a very tight rein on the game. 28 minutes gone, and the commentator now, Maurice Edelston.
A throw to Arsenal taken by left-back Bob McNabb. McNabb to Graham. Graham now to Radford. Radford in field to Graham. A good tackle coming in there from Bremner, but Graham holds on and then finds Ball. And Ball's got a little bit of room here and men on the right. The ball flowed out to the right to Armstrong. He's got good time here to get the cross in. In it comes, and David Harvey goes up as sweet as a bird. Took that beautifully, cleanly, and then throws the ball out constructively on this near side now to John Giles. Giles turning the ball infield to the ginger-haired captain of Leeds. That's Billy Bremner. Bremner's under challenge, under pressure from George, but he does a little neat heel to Madeley. And Madeley, this big strong man from left back, coming up on the far side of the field. There's just a smell of danger here to Arsenal as the ball is turned infield, and it's McClintock that clears his lines. But the ball from McClintock runs out on that far side, the Leeds left, to Eddie Gray. Gray still with it, under challenge from Storey. Gray going on the outside, if he can reach it. And there's an infringement there by Peter Storey. It'll be an indirect free kick, probably from just within or just outside the sideline of the penalty area. And little Giles, who's a very fine chipper of the ball, rather in style, reminiscent to me always of one of the best chippers of the ball in the game, that would be Terry Payne of Southampton. It's Giles going up on that far side. Chips the ball into the centre, a chance here for Leeds, and again, it's cleared this time by Radford. From Radford up to Armstrong. Armstrong flowing the ball out on the far side to Alan Ball. Alan Ball working very, very well indeed. A long ball this time, seeking out the man on this near side, and that man is McClintock. McClintock now to the overlap support fullback McNabb. McNabb turning it into the centre, headed away by Hunter. From Hunter, Graham with the interception to Ball. Ball feeding little Armstrong pretty well. A chance here for Arsenal as the ball curves in. It's a bad cross from Armstrong, and the man intercepting it quite easily was Madeley, and Madeley coolly turning it out to Peter Lorimer. Lorimer infield to Giles. Giles, the little man, holding it, cooling the tempo of the game down, but a bad one from him then. It finds Armstrong. Armstrong on the far side. Little ball is going on the outside of him, but he chips the ball into the centre, and again Harvey goes up for it. He's fouled just after he'd laid hands on the ball. He is fouled, and David Smith again, seeing the free kick, gives it immediately to Leeds United. And the ball for the moment with Leeds, with Peter Lorimer, still nil-nil. A long one downfield to Mick Jones. Jones under challenge from McClintock. Jones winning it, turning it back now to Alan Clark. Alan Clark slipping it wide now to Eddie Gray. Eddie Gray doesn't collect it, and the ball runs on the loose to John Giles. Leeds pressing as they attack from left to right. The ball from Giles to Bremner. Bremner touching it on to Peter Lorimer. Lorimer on this near side of the field. McNabb denying the way, but a good cross going in. Jones goes up, and Jones gets ahead to it. But the ball from the head of Jones over the top of the Arsenal crossbar down to our right for a goal kick. But a good, easy, fluid movement there, built up from midfield by Leeds United as Barnett now prepares to take this goal kick from the goal down to our right. Arsenal playing from right to left, a long one down the centre. Norman Hunter, the strong man of Leeds, is there. From him it runs the ball to Alan Ball, and again Ball has got a little bit of pace. Plays the ball forward to George, and Charlton, the long giraffe Charlton, has to concede a corner to Arsenal on this near side. That's the Arsenal left in this first half. Still the score, nil-nil. Hardly a whisker between these two sides. The crowd enjoying it. There's a lot of good, skillful soccer going on. The ball being played around from man to man along the ground. Good, precise, accurate passing. And little Armstrong now on this near side. That's the Arsenal left with an in-swinging corner. Aiming for the head of Radford, the big man in the Arsenal attack. In it goes. In fact, it's straight across there, and it was cleared off the line. Ball took a first-timer at it, and there on the line was Paul Reaney, and Reaney defeated Arsenal there by holding that ball with the foot just a couple of inches inside the post. What a tremendous shot by Alan Ball. But Leeds are coming back. The ball played forward by Gray. Play forward to Alan Clark. Clark now turning it to Lorimer, to Clark, to Bremner. Bremner, centre field, flicks the ball out to the far side, and that one has got too much weight on it. Defeats Paul Madeley, the left back, who'd come up on the overlap in support, and goes over the touchline, far side of the field, for a throw-in. No sun at the moment here at Wembley, but a dry day after a very wet morning. The ground in perfect condition. The ball with Bremner. Bremner feeding Giles. Giles, a lateral ball towards us and towards his right back, Reaney, but the referee has seen an infringement there against Bremner. On the person, that is, of Bremner, and this is a free kick to Leeds, halfway inside the Arsenal half and pretty much centre field. We make it 12 minutes to go to half-time, still the score nil-nil, and the Arsenal defence now taking up their deployment on the 18-yard line as the free kick is to be taken by Leeds United, John Giles. Giles arcing it to this far post for the head of Charlton. Charlton beaten by Simpson, the ball to Radford. Radford playing the ball forward again. Lorimer, though, defeating Radford. Still Lorimer with it, turning the ball in with his left foot. Gets it across. It's headed away there by Graham. From Graham it comes to Reaney. From Reaney it goes forward to McNabb. McNabb touches it forward to Alan Ball. Ball onto the chest of George. George touching it back again. This time to Ball. Playing very well now, Alan Ball. From Ball to the support fullback, Bob McNabb, on this near side of the field. McNabb now cutting infield, tackled by Bremner. A good tackle by Bremner, beats one man and slips the ball by the third, and he finds Alan Clark. And Clark going very, very fast indeed. A chance here for Leeds United. Clark's working it onto his left foot. Can he let go at this one? But he loses control just on the edge of the area. Turns it back to Mick Jones, and Mick Jones plays it with the left foot, shoots for goal, overplays it a little bit by dragging the ball, and the ball whistling past this near upright. That's the Arsenal upright. Their goal down to our right as we sit high above the Royal Box in this first half.
Norman Hunter of Leeds was soon to become the second player to be booked. This for a wild foul on Alan Ball. 37 minutes gone, and so far, a rather disappointing game.
And here come Leeds again as Rini, their right fullback, comes up in support on this near side, the Leeds right. Still Rini with it, denying him the way is Graham, and behind Graham, McNabb, the ball turned infield to Bremner. Bremner tackled by Ball, from Ball to Graham, back to Ball again. Giles goes in with a slide tackle, and the ball on the break comes to Rini. Rini arcing the ball into the centre, Jones is there, with a head, turns it back to Clark. Clark, his legs taken away from him there. No doubt at all about whether that was a free kick. The referee again, a keen eye, sees the infringement by Peter Storey. He, of course, rather like Norman Hunter for Leeds, the stern, hard winner of the ball midfield for Arsenal. An infringement by Storey then. Centre field, a free kick about 3 yards outside the penalty arc. The goal down to our right, that's the Arsenal goal. And Peter Lorimer looking as though he's going to blast his way through this solid wall in front of him. Clark has gone into that wall. There's a little bit of argy-bargy going on. David Smith making sure that they're 10 yards away, and now the Leeds players appealing, in fact, and play is being stopped for the moment. The referee now going forward to adjust this wall. It has to be 10 yards away. And this, knowing the strength in the shot of Peter Lorimer, but in fact Giles now is slipping it this way. Oh, it's a bad free kick, intercepted there, and then Lorimer shoots, and Barnett just got down to his knees and grovelled that one away for a corner kick. Well, there was a bit of a surprise, everybody anticipating that Lorimer would hit that shot. A very, very quickly taken free kick, and the ball coming back to Lorimer, and then letting fly and almost catching Barnett unawares. A corner then to Leeds on that far side of the field, to be taken by the little man, John Giles. The Leeds supporters in full cry as Giles takes this in-swinger. It's a good one. Barnett's under pressure, drops the ball, it's loose. And at the second bite of the cherry, he goes down on it and gets his hands on it. But just one or two signs there that perhaps Barnett is a little bit edgy. Didn't take that ball cleanly straight from the corner, and throws out now on that far side of the field, and the ball is into touch over that far touchline, a throw to Arsenal. Peter Storey moving back to take the throw, some 10 yards from his own corner flag on the goal line to our right, far side of the field. Storey, a long throw to Ball, Ball turning it to Armstrong. The interception by Madeley, Madeley playing it forward again, and it's Gray. Gray slipping the ball in field, good covering though by Graham, and Graham turning it back to give Barnett, his keeper, a feel of the ball to get his confidence back, and Barnett now clearing a very long one down the middle. It's a long one onto the head of Hunter. From the head of Hunter, it goes high again to Jones. Jones now to Eddie Gray. Gray playing it forward for Lorimer. A race for the ball here, but the man winning the race was, in fact, goalkeeper Barnett. And Barnett has got the ball in his hands. He's under challenge and under pressure from Lorimer. But left-footed, he clears downfield onto the head of George. George playing it out to his right. Madeley is there, so to his Armstrong. And the ball from the two of them goes to Hunter, who thunders it away into touch on that far side of the field. Still the score, 0-0.
An anxious first half for Arsenal was ending. And anxious, above all, for Jeff Barnett, the Arsenal goalkeeper, who'd been called to the colours only since the semi-final against Stoke, when Bob Wilson damaged his cartilage. And even though the first half was nearly over, there was, for Barnett, one more desperate moment to come.
Just about 15 seconds plus injury in this first half to the halfway period. And the throw to be taken by Lorimer. Lorimer now finding Eddie Gray, played back to Lorimer. Lorimer on this near side, the Leeds right, still with it. McNabb denying him the way. Still Lorimer holding and holding and holding. Lorimer still with it, turning the ball back in the end to Madeley. Madeley winning it against Armstrong, turning the ball even wider to John Giles. Giles still with it, chipping the ball over on this side to Gray. Gray in field now to Lorimer. Lorimer on the edge of the area, little 1-2 with Bremner. Bremner plays it forward again, the ball is with Lorimer. Lorimer takes the first time, and there's a good header there, and it's hit the bar from Alan Clark. Alan Clark lurking almost on the blind side, that far side of the field, and from his head that ball thundered against the bar, and I don't think Barnett knew too much about it. So a lucky escape there for Arsenal. But the ball still in play, Bremner coming forward with it, winning a free kick, claiming that he would have preferred advantage because he was moving down this near side, the Leeds right, and so it's going to be Lorimer to take this free kick, just level with the penalty area of the Arsenal side. 0-0, the Leeds fans put in their chant, the free kick goes in, the men at the back there try and rise high above it in the air, and the ball harmlessly through for a goal kick. A near escape then, Alan Clark hitting the bar there, a fine header.
There was just time for Billy Bremner to be cautioned. A postscript to a half which had given us no goals, three cautions, and some 20 fouls. A half, too, in which neither side had really impressed. But it hadn't been all dross. The attitude of the sides had at least been positive, and both had gone near to scoring. Clark and Jones for Leeds, McClintock and Ball for Arsenal. moments that had Wembley sucking in its breath. The feeling persisted, though, that neither side had done themselves justice, and that the best of this St